Hello everyone, myself A.S. Bhandare. Today we are just continue our from our last lecture, and we will be just show some another things in basics in a C programming. Today we are going to concentrate on the language translator. Let's start. Firstly, what do you mean by the language translator and why it requires? See, the language or the coding is done in between a human and a computer. Human has its own language that a human can speak in a Hindi, English or Marathi. Is these languages are known to the computer? No, computer cannot know any language which is carried out by a human. Computer has its own language. It is totally unknown about Hindi, English or Marathi. And hence, there some sort of the conversion is required. Because a human does not know computer's language and computer does not know the human language, then how the communication is carried out? So, to carry out this communication, whenever we are dealing with the coding, we require the language translators. So, a language translator basically work as a bridge between a human and a computer. They are converting the input into the another side, which one is understand by that kind of an user. So, how this translation is carried out? Basically, for this translation, we are using some kind of an software. So, we can say that the language translators used in a C programming, they are called as a system software. They are available in a software format. As I have said, these translators are used to convert the program written in assembly language into the machine language. Machine language means the language which one is known to the computer. Now, nextly, broadly, these language translators are classified into three main categories. The first is assembler, second is interpreter, and the third is nothing but the compiler. Now, we will be see one by one. First, assembler. An assembler is used to convert a program written in an assembly language to the machine language. This one is one kind of a translator. So, it is depends on which platform we are making the coding technique. So, here, this kind of the programs are generally working on a microprocessor kit. So, within that, whatever the coding is written, that is language is called as an assembly language. In that, the source program will be written in an assembly language, which is translated by the assembler into the machine language. Machine language is a language which is known towards the machine. So, generally, while we are working on a microprocessor, microcontroller kits, we ourselves works as an assembler, because the coding, whatever used over there, that language is called as an assembly level language. Nextly, it is nothing but interpreter. That is a very important thing. Now, what is this interpreter? He is also, it also a one kind of a translator. How it works? It is a translator means it is converted the one form of a language into the another form. Then how it works? First of all, the interpreter reads the program line by line. Each only single line get read by the interpreter at the instant. And then it converts each line into the machine code. So he is able to read the line, and only that a single line is converted into the machine language. Machine language is nothing but a language known to the computer. The interpreter then handovers the control to the computer after translation of the first line. Computer executes the machine code for that first line and hands over the control to the interpreter again. Again, now interpreter translates or concentrate on a second line. That second line is translated. This process will be continued till the interpreter reaches to the end of the program. If there are errors in a program, interpreter displays only one error at a time. As the interpreter is dealing only on a single line, so whenever he is scanning or concentrating on any particular line, and if that line contains any kind of an error, that error is shown by the interpreter. And unless and until you cannot remove that error, the interpreter cannot be moved towards the next line. Hence, it never proceeds until the error is removed. If interpreters are slower, and that's why it is slower, because they are working one by one line, and that's why they will be take more time to execute or to convert whole program. So we can say that the interpreters are quite slower, but they require a less memory space. There is one disadvantage, but there is one advantage. Why they will be required in the memory space? Because while they are converting, they have to concentrate only on a single line, and that's why the memory required for this conversion is very less, and hence we can say that they will be required in a less memory space. The languages like the DeepBase or FoxPro, Visual Basics, requires the interpreter for their translation. So this one is about the interpreter. So at the end, we come to the conclusion that the interpreters are the language translators. They read the program one by one line. They convert the program into the machine language one by one line. And hence, they work slowly, but they required a less memory space. So these are nothing but the characteristics or how the interpreter works. Now, nextly, there is a last one, is nothing but a compiler. Again, compiler, it is also a one kind of a translator. But is firstly, already interpreter is also available, then why there is a need to go for the compiler? Obviously, whatever the disadvantage we have just seen in the interpreter, to overcome that, we required the compiler. What is the disadvantage? Means that the interpreter is quite slower one. Then we have to move for the another one. It is nothing but a compiler. What are the highlighting features of the compiler? Is nothing but compiler translates the whole program at once into the machine language. So whatever your whole program, the same program is considered at once, and whole program the same time is going to be translated into the machine language. Interpreter consider one line at a time, but the compiler will consider the whole program from start to the end for the conversion at once. It prepares a file of the executable code, and then it can execute it by the computer. After that, the programs written in the higher level languages consist of different subprograms. The subprogram consists of different library utilities. When such programs are translated by the compiler, it first creates different object files for each subprogram. Then these object files are linked within a library to create the machine code. Nextly, the compilers are faster than interpreter. It is quite obvious, because the compiler considers the whole program at a time, against the interpreter consists of only one line at a time. So compiler will work fast. So there is no burden about the length of the program. But if the length of the program is quite larger one, the interpreter will be take the obviously a more time, but the compilers will be take a very small time. And hence we can say that the compilers are faster than the interpreters. It displays all possible syntax and semantic errors in one attempt. So whatever the programs are within the whole program, whatever the errors, they are going to be shown by the compiler at the same time or at once. Compilers requires a large memory space, but they are more commonly used. Obviously, they considered the whole program at the same time for the conversion, and hence they will be required in a large memory space. C++, this kind of an languages uses the compiler for their translation. Languages like Java use both. First, The program is compiled and then it is interpreted. It gives the advantage of an Java of becoming an architecture natural language. Now, nextly, this one is about the compiler. So, in short, we can conclude that the compiler will consist the whole program at a time for the translation, and hence it will be works more fastly, but it will be required on a more memory space. Now, we will be just see the basic difference between the interpreter and compiler, because these interpreters and compilers are more popular. This difference is obviously based on whatever the discussion right now we have just carried out. The first is interpreter. What is this work? It reads the program line by line. Obviously, on another side, the compiler reads the whole program at a time. Nextly, interpreter translate only one line of a program at a time into the machine code. But the compiler will be considered or reads the whole program at a time, so he considered translates the whole program at a time into the machine code. The interpreter produces an intermediate code after the translation, and exactly opposite, the compiler produces machine code which is indirectly understood by the computer. As the interpreter will be considered only one line, it will be required on a less memory space. But conversely, the compiler considered the whole program at a time for the conversion, and hence it will be required on a more space. The interpreters are quite slower because they are working on line by line method, but the compiler are more faster as they will be convert the whole program at a time. Just for the beginners, the interpreters are the good for the practice, but whenever we are dealing with some kind of a professional level, then the compilers are mostly used. That is, the compilers mostly used by the professionals. So this one is all about the language translators that are required for the C compiler. And also, it will be explained the difference between the interpreters and the compilers. Thank you.